Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Generations Park. This is Caterpillar's, one of Caterpillar's many displays, and showing you how we make sustainable progress possible. My name is John Disharoon, and I have the pleasure of leading Caterpillar's Sustainable Development Group. And I'm here today to talk to you about the heritage of Caterpillar, the legacy of Caterpillar, and where Caterpillar is taking sustainability in the future. When you talk about sustainable development, there are an awful lot of definitions running around out there, but at Caterpillar, we keep it pretty simple. When we talk about sustainable development, we're talking about leveraging innovation and technology to help improve the efficiency of our customers. That's right, how do we help our customers make more money, become more productive in their work environments while having a lighter footprint on the environment? It's all about the nexus of economic, social, and environmental concerns coming together in what we call making sustainable progress possible. It starts out by listening to their customers and asking them what their challenges are, and then working with our technology teams to leverage solutions, incorporating technology to give them the best answer. And as you can tell from our display here, we've got it on display in the iron. It's not just a slogan. This is what Caterpillar does. If I told you that Caterpillar had developed a track type tractor that was 30% more efficient than its predecessor, consumed 25 to 30% less fuel than its predecessor, and moved 25% more material for each liter of fuel consumed, what product would you tell me I'm talking about? Any guesses? I'm standing here next to the D7E. Most of you would say the D7E, and I'd say you're pretty close, but you're off by about 86 years. In 1925, Caterpillar introduced the Caterpillar 60 tractor, which the Holt and Best companies put together. In fact, Daniel Best had had that tractor out since about 1920, and it replaced the old steam-driven steel-wheeled tractors that were 40 feet long in the fields of California. By introducing the track-type tractor, he was able to get those big ag customers in California out into the field earlier in the spring, harvesting later in the fall with that innovative track-type technology. We didn't call it sustainability back in 1925, but that's what it was, providing solutions to our customers to address their needs. That tractor was so successful, the customers came back and said, well, we'd like a smaller one because we don't all run these huge agricultural farms. And so the Caterpillar Model 20 that you see right at the front of this show was what happened. Our engineers downsized that technology and came out with the Caterpillar 20, and we've got that antique tractor on display out there in the front. So from 1925 to 2009 on the track type tractor technology, we have been innovating technology and innovation to provide solutions to our customers. So it's about solutions in the iron. Next to the D7E, we've got a certified rebuild. It's a 980 wheel loader that had over 30,000 hours, was at the near end of its useful life. Our dealer, Wayne Supply, brought that back to their shop in Louisville, Kentucky, totally disassembled that, rebuilt it back up from the frame, took it from a tier one engine to a tier three engine, added all the engineering upgrades, gave it a new serial number, and it's sitting over here today in like new condition with a like new warranty for another 31,000 hours that it can go out there and operate. That's what we talk about when we're talking about sustainability. Certified rebuild, we're the only ones in the industry that can breathe new life into a piece of product like the certified rebuild from Wayne Supply. Even the operating characteristics of our mining products and our quarry and aggregate products that don't get a certified rebuild, they're all designed to be rebuilt, designed for emissions upgrade. So a quarry truck may go through four or five transmissions, four or five engines over the life of its useful service without getting a certified rebuild. But the certified rebuild is a frame up, transmission, engine, hydraulic systems, and electronics. Again, that's putting our money where our mouth is in talking about making sustainable progress possible. If you go to our display in ConExpo in the main show exhibit area there, you'll see how we're leveraging technology on some of our latest products. The K-Series wheel loaders is one that will stand out. Ergonomically controlled access and egress points, computerized steering assistance to help even the least skilled operators come up to proficiency in that wheel loader in the shortest amount of time possible. And standard on every wheel loader, a backup camera with full visuals inside the cab. So we've taken safety off of our factory floor, where we are now approaching world-class in safety numbers, and taking it out to everyone who comes in, on, or around our products. And it's exhibited out there on the K-Series wheel loader in the main convention center. So we leverage the technology on the components, on the systems, and the product itself. But still, every day, customers come up and say, what are you gonna do about fuel efficiency? It's fine to meet Tier 3 and Stage 3B environmental regulations, but I have to see better fuel economy. So you'll see at our Tier 4 interim and Tier 4 final product, we actually have a Tier 4 final product, the 775 quarry truck in our main main exhibit inside. We're able to improve customer efficiency, productivity, while meeting the environmental guidelines. That is sustainability in the iron. Check with all the competition and see if they are providing increased fuel efficiency with their latest tier products on display. So we take that technology that's built into the product, and then we leverage satellite technology, GPS for example, to help the customer get their job to grade quicker than they would do so manually or with human labor. Just like the GPS technology you find on your cars and your Garmins, we've got that enabled on our products to enable folks to build roads, to get those roads to grade in up to half the amount of time using 40% less fuel. That rings the register for our customers, and that's what Caterpillar's about. How can we help you make more money, improve your productivity, and have a lighter environmental footprint? I want you to take a look around the stand here that we've got today. We've built a park in the middle of an asphalt parking lot. And several folks have come up and said, well, John, I'm not quite sure this is the most sustainable thing you've ever done. Everything in this park will be reused, returned, or recycled. We think we might have about 1 to 2% waste of the consumables that'll be sorted out by the waste company. Everything else, the bricks, the benches that you're sitting on, the recycled plastic containers, the artificial grass, the lamps, all of the tiling and the sand are gonna go back to the customer, recycled or reused. All of the native plants and the greenery here at our display are gonna be turned over to the Boys and Girls Club of Nevada, and they're gonna plant them up and help beautify Las Vegas, Nevada. That's another example of how Caterpillar makes sustainable progress possible. You'll notice that all of our equipment displays here, we've got very nice women and men dressed in black pants and yellow tops. They're product experts. They're more than happy to point out the sustainability characteristics of the products, answer any product questions you have. If we don't have that answer, we'll get the answer to you. Leave us your contact information. Caterpillar means to deliver. You might have heard it at the press conference a couple of days ago. We're on a roll and we're in a hurry. We invite you along for the ride. Thanks for coming to Generations Park this morning, and welcome to ConExpo.